What's up, you fools? Matt, ESC United, your favorite Eurovision channel, and as you all know, or most of you know, all 40 songs of the Eurovision Song Contest 2020 are out. We have all the songs, we get to listen to it. That means I get to listen to them right here, right now again, and share my thoughts and react to them. Now, don't worry, I will not make you listen to all 41 songs, 3 minute long songs, because this would be a very, very long video. So I'll just listen to them and share my thoughts as they come to my mind, and we'll go from there, because you always ask, how do you feel about this song? How do you feel about that song? This will be my honest opinion. I'm trying to be respectful, but I'm also going to be honest. And that is how it goes. So let's get this thing started. Let's talk Eurovision. Alcohol You When I'm Drunk. Now, Alcohol You was actually only my fourth favorite in the Romanian national final. Initially, hear me out. In the Romanian national final, they had five songs, was number four. So I initially, when this won, I'm not going to lie, disappointed. But that revamp that was released recently really gave it the life that I was looking for. And good news, Romania, I'm now totally on board. It's probably one of the most contemporary ballads in the running this year. So, yay. I love this part. Cleopatra. No, I can't do it. I can't roll the R, so I let Effendi do it for me. Once again, maybe a few too many la la la's in the chorus, but that kick-ass sound and arrangement, it totally makes up for it. Azerbaijan uses traditional instruments and in the process create a modern sound. And I think this is amazing. Might be some people call it trash. I don't. I think it's fantastic. So, listen, the original version that Albania put forward, like, it pulled on your heartstrings. It was very powerful when she was like, it really got me. To me, the revamp version became more of a mid-tempo ballad almost. It lost some of that core emotional impact that I was feeling. So I'm a tad disappointed by the new product. I don't mind the English, even though I don't necessarily connect with it either. I just really, really preferred the original version over the revamped. But people at Eurovision, they will never get to hear the original one, so they don't have to compare it with. This is just my opinion. So, Supergirl is the great song. I love this part. It suits the singer, great memorable moments in the song, especially the kick-ass instrumental part here. I just can't get enough of that. I feel as Greece this year did everything right, and they thought this through, this song. And I have a feeling that there was so much thought put into this, as I pointed out, and it'll pay off. It'll pay off. So, with Portugal, I really can't get into Elisa's song. It may have to do with the fairly weak vocal performance in the national final, and maybe it's just a tad too niche from my taste. I wish I could feel more here, because I think that's what the song was going for, but I just don't feel it. It's just mostly boring to me, and I feel bad because I want to support Portugal this year. I still support Portugal, I'm just not into the song. Okay, I have so many opinions, but it is something. Kirkorov music, something about it. Why do I like his music? This is actually a hot mess almost. It's lyrically so weird and strange composition. See, and now we're going with this. Yet, this is a song I'm like, it's stupid. Yet, I keep listening to it. I can't help it. I like it. Prison. I don't know. I don't care. Don't judge me as much as you want. Prison. yeah, but I get it. I get it. It's a mess. Prison. I can't help it. So, Malta always seems to own the jury vote, but I have a feeling this time around, Malta can finally win back the televoters as well. Because Destiny, she has the voice, she has the stage presence, and this is a powerful chorus. Right? I will say the recipe for success is here. Let's hope that Malta knows how to cook. Don't mess it up, but it's Destiny. Just put her on stage and she'll be fine. This is a good song, Malta. I'm very pleased and very happy for you. Best of luck. It's something about Serbia. It's like strangely outdated, yet randomly modern. I can't even figure it out, regardless of whatever it is. Serbia just delivered some crazy hair-flipping choreography. And I'm not going to lie, that makes me happy. I'm thoroughly entertained throughout the entire 3 minutes, and let's be real here, it's a Eurovision fan pleaser. I am a Eurovision fan, therefore, I am pleased. Yeah, I say how flippin'. We got it, we need music like that. You just hear the song, you don't even know where it's from, but you just hear it, and you know it's a song from San Marino. I mean, they just love the disco sound of the 70s, don't they? It absolutely has that vibe that you would just expect from that country. And the song itself, I will say, is alright. But since it's San Marino, I probably like it better than I should. Like, picture this from Sweden, we would not be as thrilled. Let's be honest here. But since San Marino, maybe the bar is a little lower, I'm excited. And Sinead has so much fun. Oh, San Marino, I love you. This is only the second time, I think, or the third time? Second time I'm listening to this, and I will say, it's a grower, right? I was a bit underwhelmed the first time I listened to it, but it's actually quite good, strangely sensual. Not sure the impact it will have at Eurovision, but it's pleasant. I just think with his fantastic vocals, he's a great singer. I was hoping for something where he could showcase that. And this song doesn't really do that. But that's the song they wanted to send, and they had 250 to choose from. So yeah, it's good. This is one of those songs that will divide the Eurovision community. I can't resist Iceland this year. I just can't. Yeah, it's alright. It's alright in the studio version, but the whole live feel is just undeniably good. And does it feel a little bit amateurish? Yes, it does. But I feel as that's where the charm lies here in this song. I just like, yay! It's so weird. I just enjoy it. So, yeah. So Finland's song's a tad forgettable and safe, maybe just more than just a tad, a lot. I'm worried about Axel's stage presence as well, or the lack of it. Maybe it'll work in its favor, but to me it's just very difficult to get into looking back. It doesn't have a moment that grabs me, and therefore I lose interest like almost immediately. It's just a very forgettable song. I wish I could say more. I love this moment. Boo-hoo. Yes, I love this kind of music. I'm not going to lie. Sweden is off to a good start into the 20s, in my view. Now, the mamas give me everything that I personally look forward to in a song. Stage presence, vocals, and certainly a catchy, uplifting chorus. So there is so much going on that I just gravitate towards. So Sweden, job well done. Oh man, I'm so excited. I'll be there. Fascinating. Now this is like house club music almost. I have no idea how this is going to do at Eurovision. or live, because it's not the song that you would expect to hear live. Big question mark there yet, but when this comes on, like on my headset right now, this just is a sick sound, and I'm absolutely into it. Yes, while I cannot say how this will fare at Eurovision, it is going to fare well on my personal playlist. This part is so pretty. Now, I'm awaiting the revamped version. I don't have time to wait on this video, so I gotta move on. But I love the opening. It's beautiful. I love the powerful chorus. Oh, and her voice, Anna's voice. Mwah. But the verses are just too long. They just drag out, the song loses momentum, and then just blah, 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 drowns. Now, hopefully the revamp will have shorter verses, and they add more instruments, more sound to it to make it even sound more like water. They're already close. So this is a difficult one to judge because I don't have the full product. But I actually like it. I'm getting emotional over this song, like big time. It's a good sign. First of all, it worked over the last few years. Got the same feeling with the Netherlands, got the same feeling with Portugal, and they won, didn't they? Well, I'm just saying, let's not get ahead of ourselves. But seriously, a Bulgaria song, so beautiful. It really can be an amazing, touching moment on stage. This quiet piece where everyone just calms down. It has a special place in my heart. Bulgaria, you did tremendously well, and I will say right here, right now, this is my favorite Bulgarian entry ever. That's right. Listen, this is my 2003 Kelly Clarkson kind of music pleasure. I'm happy, so happy every time I listen to it. Even when I'm grumpy being quarantined at home, this just makes me, just gives me life, and I can't get enough of Ireland this year. I will look past the silly na 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 in the chorus. Kind of works almost here, but I will say something else controversial. Ireland, this is my favorite Irish entry over the past 20 years. 20. Yes, that's right. That's how much I love it. So, about Austria, let's say, if I was a jury member at Eurovision, I would probably give Austria a good amount of points because I can see the quality in here. As a televoter, I would probably not call in for it. It's just not that kind of music. But do you get where I'm coming from? I can acknowledge the great effort in the song and the quality here without being a song that was written from my personal taste. But I appreciate his voice. I appreciate everything about it. It just wasn't written for me. So that's just one of those odd ones. Yes. Yes. And yes, Israel. You did it again. I love the sound. I love the 34 languages in the song. I love the energy. I love everything. Everything about Fika Liby. Israel is just going to fly through the finals, right? I think we all know that. Now, the revamped version that was just recently released is more polished and almost perfect. I see great things for Israel in 2020, Eurovision-wise. So, I'm on board. I'm completely on board. So, the Netherlands, they could follow the host curse and finish at the bottom, flop big, or they could really surprise and this could work live and end up really high. It's the biggest wild card for me. Now, I hope for the latter because it's a daring choice with a sound that we don't get to hear a whole lot at Eurovision, and I personally have such an appreciation for it. It doesn't even follow like the structure of music that we're usually used to. Yeah, this verse, chorus, da-da-da. It's very interesting, and I am fascinated. And Netherlands, regardless of the outcome, whether you come first or last, my non-existing hat is off to you. Okay. So, Switzerland has finally figured out Eurovision. It's about damn time. Great song. Great voice. And a very unique vibe that the song radiates. And this has all the ingredients to go far in May. I mean, listen to that voice. And I know they're in competition there because there are a bunch of ballads in the running. But this one is very different from the rest. And I'm thrilled that Switzerland is sending something in French again. Maybe something in German next year? So, the Latvia thing here is... It's the strangest song of the year. Absolutely the strangest one. I have a bipolar opinion on this one. I like several parts of the song. Like, I love them, and some of them I loathe. Like, people love or hate this part, right? It's just so weird. So, that there's so much I love, and that's so much I hate. Does it just make it an okay song for me overall? I really don't know what to think of Latvia this year. It's the weirdest song, but maybe that's why I have somewhat of an appreciation for it, because you just can't figure it out what it is. Yes, it's Latvia. Oh, Latvia. Okay, such an interesting choice. Again, from Georgia, they always have something up their sleeve, and his voice is pure rock. And I love the desperation and the frustration that comes through here when he sings. Why don't you love me? Why don't you take me as I am? And that's powerful to me. Very powerful. I love the sound of the song. I don't know what else to say. I'm so thrilled that Georgia sends something, again, that no one else would dare to send. And I'm absolutely into it. Absolutely. Germany, my home country, they're back on track, right? I said it before that I had issues with his voice, the vocals, you know, not my kind of style. But I think what is the problem here is because the song was also auto-tuned, so his higher pitched voice sounds even higher, and it amplifies it, so live it's gonna sound a little different. So I'm gonna look past that. But overall, the song is pretty darn good. And let's not kid ourselves here, Germany will do a whole lot better than they did in 2019, which is a pretty low bar. Such a violent thing. So yeah, it's good. It's a good modern song. I'm very proud of my country. This song is probably just a tad too odd for me, but I gotta say, I'm absolutely digging like the instrumental part. I cannot deny that. This part is so cool. I'm totally into it. I mean, that's the only part I'm really into it. And I wonder, like, why am I so into it? But it reminds me of the soundtrack or the background music of one of my iPad games that I play. It has that sound, so maybe that's why I have that association. But yeah, overall, the song is maybe not quite my thing, but as long as the instrumental part is on, I'm good. Oh man, to me, I'll say it right here. My favorite Lithuanian entry ever! Absolutely! I get my Erasure 80s vibe, which is the best music ever, first of all. But with a 2020 twist, I'm always up for that. Now look, it's a quirky dance with a unique vibe, and that is going to go big in Rotterdam. I'm saying that right here, right now. I am a big fan and thrilled that it won. And ugh, I just love it. Yes. It's music that may be a little outdated. But Demir, he sings it so well. And this is why I love it. It's nostalgic. Like, positive nostalgic feelings. And that I'm getting from the song. And I can't help but love this one. Ugh. I want more of this. I can't get enough of this song. And this is one of those, I don't care what you think, I love this song. Good job, Croatia. I'm totally with you on this one. Okay. Why, France? Why? There was really a team behind this, and they listened to this and was like, yeah, that's going to be a success. I'm sorry, team behind this. I'm not trying to be mean or pick on you on this, but come on. Now, I do know that we also should expect a revamp of the song. It's going to be more acoustic, which may be a good idea. But I don't know what you can do about this. But right now, I'm... No, we're good. Okay, I will say something, and that is, I think that this is the UK's best entry in a decade, in my view. I really like it, it feels British, and yes, it will not light the scoreboard on fire. It's a neat song, though, so many good parts about it I like. I just wish they wouldn't have thought, like, okay, let's send a short song to Eurovision. It's a wasted opportunity. Use the whole 3 minutes. But other than that, yes. How could a national final, the one in Ukraine, be so bad? Terrible music, in my view. So keep that in mind. But yet, it creates such an amazing winner. Like, that was the only choice for Ukraine. And what a choice it is. I love it. And the fact it's all in Ukrainian, yay. It's just a standout piece. Come on. I hope it will receive proper recognition at the contest, because this is good. So the interesting part about Spain was it was one of the first countries to reveal their song, and it was one of the better ones at that point. But as time passed and more songs were released, they also passed them in my ranking. So now it's just somewhere in between for me. Spain overall, I wish it would be a little less repetitive, but I do like the melody, I really do. So, Belgium is pleasant. It's pleasant, but I'm worried that this will drown. I think it's a beautiful orchestration, and I'm just missing the punch. I'm missing the it factor. I want to rank it higher, but I feel as most other songs have a little bit more... that give me more than this song does. There's something missing here, and I'm sorry, Belgium, but I'm a little worried about you this year. But it's not a bad song. It's just the spark isn't there. It's a grand power ballad, right? With great vocals and so many climatic moments. Yet, I personally fail to connect emotionally with it, and that's probably a problem, but I do have an appreciation for what it is. But there are ballads in the running that I personally gravitate towards more than attention, but it's not a bad song at all, and she sings it so well, so well. And now, talking about climatic, So there were so many years that I appreciated Australia. Kate was the best thing ever last year. And what I've gotten used to Don't Break Me, like, I've listened to it a few times now, so I'm like okay with it now. The song just never ever completely won me over. When I did my reaction video for the Australian National Final, this wasn't even in my personal top 5 in that National Final, so I think that says it all. So, it's not hateable, it's just other songs speak to me more. So this song cracks me up every single time. Now, the craziest song in the running this year, right? And the most polarizing song as well, I would say. But we all know, in the end, that this will just set the televote score on fire, right? They will like it. Don't know about the juries, but the televoters will love it. I love it, too. Like, even if you hate it, like, you just want to listen to it. Like, it's like a drug. It's like... It's just... I can't help it, but I'm so into this. Alright. Czech Republic. I feel like... The people sleep a little bit on Czech Republic. I mean, they're still deciding what version to use. I hope they're going with the first one, which is superior. But the original one, as I said, is really good. And it works well live more than anything. So I'll say stop ignoring Kimama. Pay attention, people. This could do much better than we all think. Oh man, I don't know what it is when it comes to Kukuro's kind of music and why I like it so much. I think that this is old-fashioned sound that takes me back to my younger childhood. My parents listened to this kind of music, like this German 80s Schlager music style. I have a soft spot for it, and I really, really, really like this. Holy. Yeah, so they've had tough luck with the juries as of always, I guess. Now, I think that could potentially end this year in the 2020 year. It just screams jury pleaser, doesn't it? I mean, what a voice. A grand ballad that is even better live. The studio version is already really good, but it really comes alive when you watch it on stage. Great voice, and I'm into it. I'm into it. Take me to the party. I always think she says, take me to the party. Like, you have to go potty? Is that what it is? No, seriously, this is not the revamp version that finally came out, and it definitely added more gravitas and more sound to it, to the arrangement. Like, the chorus is more full and complete. I still wish they would have gotten rid of the Jamaican steel drum sound. It just doesn't work for me in this sound. No, Armenia has lost their Eurovision groove lately, and I don't know if 2020 will bring it back just yet, but let's just say she is definitely a star. Like, she has the stage personality to make it work, and this could actually be quite entertaining on stage. It's just not my favorite song. So, Denmark? That's one thing I'm asking you, well, not you people of Denmark, but the people in charge, fix the staging. Make these two interact with each other. Don't be like all separated on stage. This is an uplifting song. You need to be close and bring warmth to the song. That's not happening with the staging right now. That being said, I love this song. I love this song, and this is one of Denmark's better entries, and you've had a good amount of good songs, but this is just really good. I once again just love Italy every single year. What is going on? The chorus just melts my heart. It is so beautiful, so powerful. I feel it. I don't speak the language. And that is the best part about it. Every single year, Italy. I'm sick and tired of it, which is a lie. I'm not sick and tired of it at all. Good job. Good job. There you have it, my thoughts on all 41 entries. You heard it, my thoughts. It's okay if we disagree on some of the entries. I think overall this is a very, very strong year with just a few boo-boos in between. And now I would love to hear from you where you agree, where you disagree, and let's be kind to one another. This is what we love, Eurovision, and let's treat it accordingly and give it the respect it deserves, meaning don't be mean to me. I gotta go. Let's move on to the next video. Thank you for watching and have a good day. Bye.